Today we're diving into 5 more note-taking applications. Now, I did a video very recently summarizing some of the best note-taking applications on the market, and I think we covered about 15 of them. So if you haven't seen that video, do check it out below. And if you want to see Toolfinder with all of the note-taking applications, you can find that linked below. But I missed a few, so today's video, we're going to go over 5 additional ones that might be helpful for your note-taking experience. Before we begin, my name is Francesco. Welcome to Keep Productive. Do hit subscribe. We'd honestly love to have you as a subscriber. Join us, become part of our community, and hit the like button if you do enjoy this video throughout. So 5 more productivity applications that are specific for notes. Now, we've talked about a few here on the channel. OneNote is one that I missed off the list, and I did it purposefully. OneNote is such an awesome application, but I typically try to recommend third parties on top of this. But Microsoft OneNote is probably one of the gold standards for academic and general use. It really compares to the likes of Evernote, producing a great experience for taking notes, and really going that step further if you've got Windows devices, in particular with sketchnoting and ways to capture things too. OneNote is used by probably millions of people around the world, and it has some really grade A applications to go along with it on pretty much all devices. Number 2 is NotesPlan. Now, NotesPlan 3, it's in its third version, is a really nice experience. Now, if you're looking for something that's very Apple-centric, that presents you with a way to manage your notes, calendar, and tasks in one base, this could be a great application for you. Now, it really centers around Markdown, but it does help you to organize your calendar events alongside your notes, which is perfect for planning out stuff. Not so much as good as agenda notes for the calendar notes experience, but it does help you to plan your tasks and your notes and your calendar together. And it's great if you've got an Apple calendar system that weaves into this, if you've built it around that, because it helps to really keep them synchronized. And NotePlan is really well designed, maybe not as beautified as a finishing piece as OneNote, but presents a really interesting opportunity if you're a Markdown lover as well. Number 3. Now, I actually hadn't checked out Upnote before I did the video, and then I did a full review on it. If you haven't seen that review, I give it very good ratings. To be honest, Upnote really impressed me. It compares to the likes of Bare Notes, but presents a really, I would say, reliable, easy to use experience for those who want something a little bit more advanced than Apple Notes, but not as advanced as Evernote, somewhere in the middle, and a fairly reasonable pricing too. So I would give Upnote a very credible rating, because from my experience of using it and playing around with it, I was pretty well impressed. So next up is Tana. Now, a lot of people have been hearing about Tana. It's basically Rome reborn. I don't mean to say that to offend a lot of people, but it's a PKM tool that has a lot more depth than some of the PKM tools on the market. Now, it's got things like super tags, these different views that take it even further. And I've seen a lot of teams use it as well. It's really interesting to see the evolution of Tana. So Tana is really in a very early stages, currently only in beta or even alpha access, I think, which means it's very early stages, but it's making a huge amount of waves in the PKM space as a potential takeover for Obsidian, Logseq, and even Rome Research as the go-to PKM tool. So it'll be interesting to see how Tana evolves over the next year, and very much an interesting development in the space. Number 5 is Nimbus Notes. Now, I was surprised I didn't add this in the first version. Sometimes, like a human I am, I make mistakes with missing certain tools out. Even missing Microsoft OneNote out is a big mistake in initial listicle. But Nimbus Note is a great alternative to Evernote. It provides very similar features, but has some more advanced capture functions when it comes to screen recordings and being able to capture stuff on the web. That's a bold statement, because Evernote has some great web clippers, but it does have some really interesting screen capture technology. Now, Nimbus Note presents a very similar experience. It doesn't really go as much further, but it does have a much cheaper pricing for the premium. If your budget is squeezed, this is a great alternative to Evernote for bringing that price down. So Nimbus Note, a great alternative to Evernote, presenting very similar features. And finally, a little bonus one for you. For those who know Obsidian, well, Obsidian actually wasn't the first project from the team. The first project, well, to my knowledge of note-taking, was Dynalist. Now, Dynalist has been used by many individuals that like outliner technology. For those who don't know outliner technology, it's the technology that inspired the creation of apps like Workflowy, which we'll mention in a moment. But Dynalist presents a great way to keep it simple, bullet points, and deepening those bullet points. And we did a video a few years back with Herb, who I met at an event, who dives into how he uses Dynalist. And wow, it's absolutely incredible how he keeps that all organized. And it is great to see how you can keep an app so simple, but really take it a lot further. So I recommend checking out that video from Herb Cordell. Fantastic video. And number seven as well, Workflowy. Again, very similar to Dynalist, but probably the OG in this space, having a lot more features than Dynalist, because I think that Dynalist has sort of been left behind with Obsidian taking first place. But Workflowy is a really good all-round experience that people love to use on web and also on their devices. So hopefully you found additional note-taking applications. I'm sure we'll do some more. There's obviously tons more out there, and I'm probably going to get battered for not including Notes Nook and things like that. But we will cover them very soon, folks. You can imagine how difficult the job is and our team's job to find all of these apps, categorize them, and work out what they are. We hope we found one for you today. Anyway, folks, a big, big thank you. I look forward to seeing you in a future video here on Keep Productive. As I said, find them all on Toolfinder, and we'll see you in a future video. Cheerio, folks.